Hello dear Steemians, Dtubers, members of Uptrend and all beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpa and this is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies. And on the site of CoinGecko, we see that Bitcoin is trading at the level of $6,751 and it is a solid rise for the for the last 24 hours. Even earlier today, the price of Bitcoin was very close to the level of $6,800. And even on some exchanges, I saw prices close to $7,000. And as we see today, most of the other cryptocurrencies that are in top 10, they also followed within these 24 hours the price trajectory of Bitcoin, and Ethereum was trading over the level of $190. Litecoin was trading a couple of hours ago at levels close to $88-89 at some exchanges. So we see that the cryptocurrency market the prices of the major cryptocurrencies are rising and rising, and it's really great. But let's have a look at the price chart of Bitcoin on the site of CoinGecko, of course. And this is the price chart on 1 day time frame. So 1 day time frame on 1 day chart is quite a significant time frame for technical analysts and for financial analysts researching the crypto market. And once again, I just want to let you know that we have a solid resistance line or level, or actually, as I used to say before, in my view, it's a solid resistance range within this range. And we see that the price of Bitcoin, or the chart of Bitcoin, at the moment is trying to break through this solid resistance range or level. And to be honest, let's remove this line. I just want to show that at the moment, the current prices of Bitcoin, or the current level of the price of Bitcoin, is challenging the previous high or maximum or top on the chart. And that's why I will say that at the moment, the price of Bitcoin is trying to challenge the bear market, to put an end to the bear market, or to question the further continuation of the bear market. But this is just for today. It is challenging the bear market, so I won't say that this is the end of the bear market. That's why we will have to keep an eye on the charts, and that's why I want to show you something interesting on a 1 week chart. Of course, we see that we still have this sequence of candlesticks that have ascending highs and ascending lows, so it is a bullish pattern or signal. But I just want to let you know that if we have a look at this candlestick, we see that at the moment the price is close, a little bit higher, but close to the levels of the last high. And this is where everything started back in November of 2018, when the price of Bitcoin rapidly dropped significantly, and most of the cryptocurrencies, they follow this price dynamic of, or trajectory of the price of Bitcoin. And when Steem even dropped to 20 cents a bit later in the second half of November, or at the very beginning of December, for example. And I just want to show that on a 1 month time frame, now the sequence of the last candlesticks, bullish candlesticks, is trying to engulf, to cover the sequence of those last bearish candlesticks on the chart. And this is this solid candlestick, bearish candlestick, that was formed in November 2018. And for me, it will be very, very important to see if at the end of this month, at the end of May, we will be able to engulf the body of this candlestick, and we will see this, let's say, bullish engulfing, in case the price of Bitcoin at the end of the month, at the end of the current month, is at levels close to the current levels. But imagine that we see in the coming days or weeks, in the next few weeks, or in the second half of May, some kinds of price drawback, then it will mean that that was just an attempt to challenge the bear market, and it is a fake signal, and it's not an end. It's not the end of the bear market, because we may see a little bit later. Imagine this worst scenario on a monthly, on a 1 month chart, some kind of candlestick that has a small body that is within the body of this solid red candlestick or bearish candlestick, and that candlestick has a solid, very tall shadow, upper shadow, so the upper shadow may be quite tall, and then it will turn out that at the moment that was a fake bullish signal, or it was just an attempt to challenge the bear market. That's why we have to wait, and let's see what will happen on the chart of Bitcoin when we check this chart at the very beginning of the next month, of namely of the month of June. So of course I am really very happy, because we all are cryptocurrency enthusiasts, but we have to be cautious and to check the price charts, the monthly price chart, at the very beginning of June, and we will see if we will still have this bullish engulfing. And now let me switch to some interesting news. Of course, as we see, Bitcoin is rising. If we switch to all those media outlets covering or highlighting or spotlighting or talking about the cryptocurrency market, we see all those beautiful and extremely positive news. For example, on the site of Cointelegraph 16 hours ago was published the following news. Financial advisory firm says past market trends point to Bitcoin at 20,000 by 2021. And that's actually the company of Canaccord Genuity that predicted that Bitcoin could hit 20,000 by 2029, and they use some kind of projections or forecast based on some other cycles on the price of Bitcoin during 2011-2015, the first cycle, the second cycle, 2015-2019, and etc. So they just apply such kind of analysis, and they predict that Bitcoin will hit 20,000 again in the next 2 years. Of course, if we have a look at some other news, they are also very positive, because nowadays we see this price increase on the price chart of Bitcoin. And that's why all of a sudden again pop up the news about Tim Draper, the billionaire that is very famous cryptocurrency enthusiast. And he said in an interview for Fox News in the United States that Bitcoin will take 5% of the global market share by 2023. And of course, Cointelegraph reiterated again that earlier he said that price of Bitcoin will hit $250,000 by 2023. So we see this massive positive news about the price of Bitcoin again, such kind of news that Bitcoin will hit $10,000, for example. Michael Novogratz said that a few days ago, 20,000, 50,000, now 250,000. They're just popping up and popping up. And let me tell you, in my view, why it happens. Because, fellas, I have also worked with such kind of media outlets. For example, that's me when I used to work as a cryptocurrency analyst for one of the biggest brokerage companies here in Russia. I used to work, for example, with Forbes as well, to comment on ICOs, on cryptocurrency market, on different coins, etc. I even used to work with Cointelegraph as well, since I was cryptocurrency analyst for one of the biggest brokerage companies in Russia. And for example, that's me again in the news in Cointelegraph. That's my name, Veselin Petkov. I commented on some kind of know your customer bills about the regulations here in Russia, and etc. So What I want to say is I also used to work with all those news outlets, many outlets, and I know how this industry works. And now let me tell you a few words. When I was when I started working in this industry, like the financial industry, stock markets, commodity markets, forex, later cryptocurrency market, at the very beginning, during the first 2 or 3 years working as a financial analyst and trading all those currency pairs, stocks, and etc., because I worked for a hedge fund. I started to work for a hedge fund back in 2006 that used to invest in those financial markets. And as junior analyst, or as junior analysts, we used to think that we have to read the news, to check Bloomberg, to check CNN or some kind of news about the stock markets. And when you watch the news and you read the news, you will know what will happen and you can make some wise or good investment decisions. Actually, it doesn't work so. And if you watch the news, and such kind of news like in the media outlets, or you read the news, at the end of the day you will realize that in the long run all of or most of your investments will be unsuccessful. And let me explain you why. Because this industry, the media, works completely different. They see the price charts, they see some increases, and that's why they needed the moment to explain to the audience what happened, why the price of Bitcoin is rising. And they bring to the media industry or space positive news. If tomorrow the price chart changes its direction and the price of Bitcoin starts to draw back, then they will bring the negative news, because at the moment there are many positive news and there are many negative news, and they will just pick up if they need the good news. If they need at the moment bad news, they will bring to this media market the bad news. So that's why, fellas, be very careful. And it is always like this on all financial markets. If the prices are going up and up, then the journalists and the people working in this industry, they will bring the good news to explain you what happened. And keep in mind, most of those people are even not professionals that work for those media outlets, unfortunately. And they even don't know how those financial markets work, but they are good at writing, and they also are good speakers. And that's why be very careful. And once again, if tomorrow, for example, the price of Bitcoin starts to draw back, they will bring the negative news, they will create some noise. For example, they will tell you some attorney somewhere in the United States or in Argentina said that they will put an end to the cryptocurrency industry in their region. They will bring to court some funds and etc. And they will try to increase the noise about this event. And most of the people will start to believe, oh, that's why the price of Bitcoin is falling, because the Security and Exchange Commission in the United States said that they will do something with the cryptocurrencies. Actually, those are such insignificant news, but media over-exaggerate them. They just exaggerate them, make them seem important to the people. And most of the people that are not familiar with that industry, they base their decision on such kind of news. So fellas, be very careful. Once again, I just want to let you know that media works like this. If the prices are going up, a little bit later they come and they start to bring the positive news. They're always late. The media is always late. And when the price, for example, of the asset starts to drop, and if it is going down and down, a bit later the media come and they bring the negative news. So be very careful. That's why I just wanted to let you know that as a financial analyst working in this industry for the last 13 years, I also used to work with some media outlets. And I even, for example, when they call you, when they used to call us for such kind of prominent, famous media outlets, they used to ask us, hey, you're a cryptocurrency analyst or you're a stock equity analyst. Can you explain why and write an article for our media? What happened today and why the price of this asset, for example, dropped? And I say, because it was overvalued. It was overvalued 4 months ago. And this is just the continuation of that price getting lower and lower. There is no reason or explanation why the price dropped today by 5%. It's just continuation of some drop. And they say, no, but we need to explain to people what happened exactly today. And we, the cryptocurrency and equity analysts and macroeconomists, used to always try to explain to those people working for those media outlets that there is no trigger, there is no reason, there is no any fundamental factor that explain why exactly today the market dropped. It's just supply and demand or trading on the exchanges. But they need this news and they will create something just to make it looks interesting in order to attract visitors to their sites, to read their news and be very careful. That's it for today's fellas. That was me again at Crypto Spa. I hope you enjoyed this video. Hope to see you in my next video and have a great weekend.